With Dragon Ball Madness looming over the horizon while Street Fighter 6 still has a hold onto my heart, I thought to myself, man, wouldn't it be great to use the 5v5 CPU team tournament format onto the exciting fights of Street Fighter 6? Well, it turns out you can. So for this video, I've crafted four amazing teams for a survivor style fight where health and meter carry over in a quest to see who's the real top tier Street Fighter. Here we go, Luke versus Chun-Li. Let's get this party started. Ooh, Sam, let's start it. Oh, the overhead. All right, Luke got a DP of his own. Two of them. Hey, level 8 will cross cut on you. But Chun-Li's got her combos. You know what she does. Ooh, good spacing by Luke. Flash knuckle combo, you got those? No, you got a drive rush instead. Okay. Ooh, you're steamrolling Chun-Li right now. And a throw in the corner. I know what happens here. Okay. Chun-Li text those. Ooh, good combos. But Chun-Li's still in a pretty bad spot here. Ooh, target combo by Luke. Oh, again. There it is. Luke steamrolled Chun-Li. It's looking pretty good for the new generation. The old dogs are gonna have to learn some new tricks, I'll tell you that. Now, speaking of new guard versus the old guard, we got the army brat versus the family man, Luke versus Guile. He just EX sent, what? Nah, Luke is different. Luke has a mission to prove. A DDT? This is getting nasty. Guile, you gotta put on for your team. Somebody's gonna have to carry, because Luke has his team on his back. What's Guile gonna do? Good anti-air. Ooh. DI? The counter DI by Luke? You just can't stop him, can you? A flash knuckle combo? You just cannot stop him. Luke's just a good, humble guy. He's just a himbo. He's not Shadaloo. The no Shadaloo team has like minus 10 stats because of that. Amy's gonna try to do her best here, but oh, we're making a statement. Level three off rip. Cammy's making that statement. You gotta applaud it. Now, granted, she didn't have to do that, but a statement has just been made nonetheless. Can she at least get to Kimberly? If we get to Kimberly, then no Shadaloo will be able to have a good fighting chance, at least on paper. All right, but it all depends on what Jamie's gonna do, and he just starts with a DP. Oh no. Ooh. He's getting to it. He hasn't even drunk anything yet. Oh, I think he's about to. Yeah, he's at drink one. Kimmy's in a terrible spot in the corner. Jamie's just bullying her. He's got a level 3 of his own. He's got statements of his own. It's different now. Ooh, will he convert off this? He does. Oh, he did. Perfect parry. Cammy, she's got Jamie in the corner. What happens here? A dive kick happens there. Jiri's got one hell of a mountain to climb. We gotta see if she does it. She stops the palm, so that's pretty good so far. All right. They're just feeling each other out right now. It's nothing too crazy. But Jiri's getting a good win on most of these encounters, and a counter DI by Jiri. I think this is it for Jamie. I don't see how Jamie could win after this. Ooh, and then a level 3. I think that's for the best. I don't think Jiri was going to be able to kill off it. Technically, this is a perfect, but hey, perfect. I think I might be crazy, but I think that Jiri might have what it takes. Genuinely speaking, I could be wrong, but I could also be correct. Ooh, EX DP. No, that was just a regular DP. Nice. Ooh, she's winning the encounters. Aw, man, Kim is not getting any offense in, and she's already in the corner. That's the last place that Kimberly wants to be. Ooh, counter poke. Okay. Kimberly's got some breathing room, but I don't think Jiri's gonna let her have it for free, and we're back in the corner, and Kim's done. Nah, they're evened up. Aki's got the meter advantage, but numbers-wise, Jiri's doing everything that she can. Give Jiri a raise. Hashtag give Jiri a raise. Okay, floor projectile. And to a level 1? I don't know if I would have gone with that bar, but I understand it. Made her make a mistake. Another DP to punish the jump. Aki's got to find a way to get in, but Jiri wants to get in too. and she's winning all these encounters. Aki's at a third of her health left. She did not DP that jump in. Aki's got a fighting chance now. Ooh. A lot of pokes. Acupuncture. The Magnum Opus. Okay. How's Aki gonna fix this? Ooh. She dodged the floor projectile. It's time for some corner combos. This is how Juri did to... Ooh. She fought her way out. Never mind. But it didn't matter. It didn't matter. Aki wins. Come on, Rashid. Don't let the team down. Ooh. Hey. Oh, he did not counter DI. He was in a perfect position to do so. I don't think he had it on the brain. But now Rashid's in the corner with some poison on him. Oh, he got some offense in. I think he might be able to take out Aki. Wait. Ooh. There it is. Good spacing by Rashid. You gotta apply no shadow loose spacing here. You got to. Now it's time for top tier JP versus okay, Rashid. You know, your EX DP can get counter hit. People start casting agendas, you know. Ooh, but Rashid's already got JP in the corner. I don't think JP wants to be there. He wants a full screen fight. You gotta respect it. Ooh, the portal failed. Ah, he got kicked there. Throwing it. JP's got reactions. He may be old, but he's got... Oh my god, a level three. I couldn't believe my eyes. He connected that. It ended in ruin for the team of No Shadaloo. No Shadaloo will be moving to the loser's bracket, and we will be getting on with the next fight.
Get into the ring. This will be a good fight.
And we're off. The Pride of Japan, E Honda versus the other Pride of Japan, Ryu. A headbutt. Aw, Honda does mean business here. Even more business. He's got combos. Oh, this is different. I've never seen a Honda with combos in rank. This is art. And Ryu is just getting bullied in this corner. Oh my goodness. Ooh, Ryu's got some fighting back in him. But he cannot get touched here. Oh, he dodges the command throw. Okay. He's got to keep it up. All right. Ah, the butt slam. It makes fools of us all. Now we've got E Honda versus Marisa. Ooh. That air-to-air was crazy. I didn't know a Honda had buttons for that outside of the butt slam. Carrying the drive impact. Marisa needs to be a little more aggressive. But otherwise, just like that? We're just gonna make a statement just like that? That was a waste of bar, but good lord, it was flashy. The people do love flashy. Now we're gonna have Marisa versus Blanca. I have no idea what's gonna happen here. I know a Blanca ball's coming, I'll tell you that much. I know if I could trust a headbutt from Honda, you can trust a Blanca ball from Blanca. He's got like that move in just five different trajectories. Ooh, not quite. The Superman punch missed. Now Blanca's got his time and he's gonna go for a level three. Now that's how you spend your meter. I don't wanna criticize Marisa, that's my baby. But ooh, that's a really smart use of meter. Now Marissa's at 55 health. Left. It don't matter though. Marisa just evened it up because that's my baby. That's what she do for real. Oh. Blanca ball. Anti-air that. Blanca's not going to be allowed to see his son. He might. Oh. Is this it? Nope. Yeah, that's going to be it with a level one. He built that bar and that combo. I hate it had to be her. But Blanca's got a lot of health missing, though. If anyone can do it, DJ should be able to do it. It's time for Blanca to know Wagwan. Oh, and Blanca knew Wagwan. He's got a counter drive impact. Okay. He is going to have to fight smarter, not harder here. Is he mad close in the corner? And he's in that corner. Oh my goodness. Blanca is just peeling health away like it's a plantain. Yeah, that DJ soul is gonna have to be up to Lily, right? Like, what, Ken is like, what, bottom three, right? Like, it's gonna have to be up to Lily in order to fix everything. Okay, Blanca just set up his son. Lily wants no patience for that. I think she just did it. Ooh. And fortunately for her, the drive gauge does carry over, so Lily does not have to worry about burnout. The meter, on the other hand, But Lily did it. It's one thing to fight against the Brazilian menace, but when you have to fight up against the Red Cyclone, who's wearing orange? It's different here. Oh my god, he gripped her. Oh my god. Okay. Nah, Lily does not care about your plus frames. Okay. The windstock was plus. Why didn't she get some offense in? Because she wanted a counter DI. She's smart. She's playing chess. We're all just playing checkers. Uh-oh. I know a geek looking for a grip. He missed it. Lily's gonna have to do a little more than that, but I understand it. Careful now. Oh. I forgot what move this is called. But this is the Super Lariat. Is he good? Oh my god, he's great. He's the greatest. That was a crazy conversion. Geef did not have the anti-air and he died for it. Lily still got gas in the tank. But now it's time for Lily versus Manon. This, I think it's about to get scary. I think whoever wins this won it for their team. And I think Manon just did it. Oh, Lily's got the pokes. Now she's gripping. Oh no. It's getting spicy. I don't think Lily had a choice but to take that, but unfortunately Lily could not get it done. Manon lost half her health, but I think she's gonna get a good chunk of it back. Yeah, she's at 70% now. I don't know what Ken's gonna be able to do to get around this. Ooh, throws the DI, a little bit of a weak idea. Oh, we're doing a throw loop. Hey man, Ken's playing the game, man. It's not an honorable game, but it's a game instead. Okay. Oh, let's go, Justin. Good old kid. He lost his wife, lost the kids, but he ain't losing these fights, and that's what matters. He heard JP was next up. He wants to fight JP. You have to respect it, but to fight JP, he's got to get around the greatest scrub killer of them all, Dawson. And Dawson is winning neutral. I'll tell you what, I don't know how Ken's going to get around this. Oh, he just does. Good spacing. Ken's punches just win. You could cut to the credits now. Thanks for watching. Ooh, and Dawson's getting bullied in the corner. Hey. And with that, Team Fair and Honest will honestly and fairly go to the winner's final. And here we go in the loser's bracket. We've got the Scrub Killers versus No Shadaloo in the opposite order, as you see. But it doesn't even matter. How are we starting this off? A headbutt from Honda, and he gets a chop in. Oh, Honda's winning these War of the Spaces. Ooh, and Chun-Li's already in the corner. We've seen what this looks like before, but Honda got a little too greedy for a command grab, and, well, you see where that went. Ooh. But it doesn't matter. Honda's winning these buttons here. Okay. Chun-Li's got to work a little smarter here. I think she just did it. She cashed out and she took out Honda. Good job. Good showing. All right, she got bullied by Luke in that first round. But I think she warmed up now, man. That's the thing about old folks, right? That's the thing about the old generation. Gotta warm their joints up before they can really cook. But when they cook, you see why they were the goats of their time. Doesn't even matter though. Blanc is... Oh, they'll DI on the Blanca ball. It's a tricky thing. I understand, Sean. And then a sweep? I thought we were ethical people here. All right, Guile versus Blanc. I have no idea how this is going to go. A Sonic Boom already? I guess I should have known how this was going to go. Ooh, always be charging. Guile's got those Sonic Booms at the ready, but also Blanca's got them balls. Hey, Guile combos, baby. Blanca sat on it. He's got to do a grounded game now. This is Guile we're talking about. Blanca ball into a level 3? And it connected? What are we doing here? Blanca's got the hashtag privilege. Okay, we gotta do something about Blanca's son. Guile finds a way, but Blanca, I think, wants to put him in burnout. But Guile's got a level 3 of his own, and I think that plays, that kills. The somersault. It kills, baby, it kills. Now, Gao versus Zhang Gi. Some cultured individuals would say that Gao is absolutely about to rock Zhang Gi. If you know the old classic story of a zoner versus a grappler, but I don't think Gi cares about your estimates because he's not a normal human. He's a freak of nature. Gi evens up the score. Now he's got to fight Akami at full health. They both have around the same amount of meters. Geef is now punishing jump-ins. Oh no, dare I say it's different now. Akami was not able to get like an ounce of offense in when I was speaking my first sentence, but now she got a little more in and Geef is gripping her back. Oh man, Geef got too greedy. He got too greedy, you can't do that. What happens here? Oh, drive rush into level two. Akami's cooked. Akami's cooked! Oh! Jury versus Geef. This is an interesting match, I'll tell you what. Good old Geef with a drive impact. Punching her. Nah, Geef wants to win this neutral at all costs. Jury is not gonna let him know. It's not that easy. Oh! Counter DI from Jury. Ah, here comes the damage. A level three? Ah, I did not know she had that many bars stored up. I don't know if it's wasteful because I don't think the level one would have killed. You kind of have to acknowledge that they had to do that. So the score's evened up now, but tough to say who's in a better spot. Air the projectile. Jury still gets her offense in though. You can't jump in against somebody with a DP like that. Did it again. Jury's got her bread and butter and it's working every time. The spacing is rough. Jury's cooked. Not Jury, Manon is cooked. Oh, Manon's getting a medal. I know what happens here. I've watched many a Manon fight. Jury's not gonna let it be easy, but you whiffed the throw. You whiffed the throw. You can't do that, Manon, and now it's Dalsum's time. Potentially, this is his home. He shaved his beard and everything, got to his old clothes, reminded himself where he came from. Potentially, he might put the team on his back for this. He's got three bars. He is in the corner, though, and Jury does like to bully people. Hey. All right. Yeah, Jury is pressing those buttons, and all her buttons are working, but Dalsum just got a level three confirmed. Okay, all right. This does not kill, but I think this does put Jury in a terrible spot. Yup. There it is. Dalsum remembered who he's doing this for. Cannot believe my eyes. I tell you what, I could not believe my eyes. We are tied up. Dalsum versus Rashid. I cannot tell you who's going to win this one. Rashid's got the best advantage, but he's got to get in order to press those advantages, and I think Dalsum's got it for him. He tried to DI and that was the best idea. All right, if Rashid gets a touch here, he's going to convert for a level three, mark my words. So Dalsum's going to get him away first. Good tornado there. All right. Dalsum's got to get out of the corner. And he does. He's about to put Rashid in it. Rashid's looking pretty bad, but one touch is all it takes for Rashid. He just got hit. Level three. It's not a critical art, it's just a regular level 3, so I don't think it's gonna kill, but... Dalsum's gotta be super careful here. The same side teleport, it didn't do anything because he was in the corner, and now the EX reversal. Rashid pulls through. The scrub killers have died. We got Luke versus Ryu. It's time for a passing the torch kind of match, I'll tell you what. It's all about what happens here. Ryu gets a perfect parry off and he gets his offense in. Luke ain't looking too good. Oh, counter throw, my bad. Oh, overhead, yeah. That flash knuckle counter is my bread and butter, I'll tell you what. Shout out to Luke for getting it off. They're trying to figure out where their buttons lie. Hey, DI the fireball. That's a free punish right there. Are we gonna see a flash double counter? A flash knuckle combo, mind me. Hey, another DI on the fireball. Ryu just blows up from it. He died twice to it. Ken also has a fireball, he's gonna need to pay attention. DJ has a fireball, he's gonna need to pay attention. Luke had Ryu's number, dude. You never want to see that kind of thing. Now it's Luke versus Marissa. There's no fireball over here. It's just plus frames. Ooh, that's what I'm trying to tell you. Okay. Now we're back at the even. Marissa was ready for the jump. Ooh, plus frame there. EX Gladius. She didn't counter that. You gotta be ready for that DI. Luke has been showing he wants to do it, and he got a level 3 combo in. This is not good for Marissa. Now, Marissa does have 3 bars, and if you fought a Marissa in ranked, you know that this means that she could win, but she opts for a level 2 instead? What is she cooking? Not even an EX DP. She's done. She wanted to stunt and it failed. It cost her. I hate to see Marissa go out like that, but Luke is cooking like he cooked in his first debut fight. Can DJ be the one to stop it? I don't want to hold somebody's past record against them, but maybe let's not bet on DJ too much. Okay. We got some shimmies. We got some feints, but Luke's got some target combos. You gotta be prepared for that. Oh, DI. Nice. He had a great idea. He hit the funky rhythm. I can't promise to know what's gonna happen at this fight. DJ may have to incorporate the fireballs, but it doesn't matter. Jamie goes ahead and jumps over them. Just one drink. Oh, the faint. DJ's just cool, man. He's just cool. Ooh, another anti-air? Not quite, but it kinda worked. Jackhammer fist in a level 3? Does this kill? Hey. No way. DJ moving like a JoJo's character? By God, it killed. The score has been evened up. DJ saw the tweets. He saw the negative remarks on his performance. He said he's gonna step it up. Now it's DJ versus Kimberly. You hate to fight your favorite fans, but it's gotta happen. Ooh. Hey, good idea, but it was not working. Kimberly's trying to get away in. He's just not letting it happen easily. DJ's got everything on point now. Kimberly's gonna have to fight a little more patiently. It don't even matter if you're too patient. DJ will just grab you. Kick. Hey! Aki versus DJ. Now, this is where I think things might get a little spicy. Hey, DI, it doesn't matter where things get. If DJ don't take it there, and then a jackhammer? Man. We got some poison on the field. It don't matter. Counter, DI. I think we're going to see a level 3 combo there. There it is. Aki is leaking because of this. I don't see how. I think we're gonna have to pass this to JP. I think we just gotta pass that to JP. A DI in the corner. She's cooked. Where was this DJ? Shout out to Ken. But where was this DJ, man? Counter DI on DJ. I don't know why JP just did that. He's playing like he's me. Big combo here. That's a 30% health for that. What's JP gonna do now? I think we're seeing a level 3. There it is. How does this end, JP? How does this end? What's his plan here? Just a walk-up throw, and it didn't work. Bad spike. He is playing like he's me. Okay. Yeah, he's gotta be mad careful. He's gotta be more careful than that. Does DJ have rhythm? 4, 5. He has enough rhythm. DJ soloed the entire team. We said DJ ain't got it no more. And DJ said, who though? Luke versus Chun-Li. Here we go. EX Sandblast. We gotta make a statement here. And a DP. Nothing Chun-Li can do works. Never mind. She just got a combo in. Is it different now, Chun? No. He's got the CMP of a god. Luke does. And now it's time to bully somebody in the corner. Okay, Chun. Get yourself out there. Ooh. Good poke there. All right. Chun fought it back, but Luke just got his way. Chun Li put up a much better fight than before, but that's still a pretty solid performance by Luke. Like, he's still looking like a strong contender, but Luke versus Guile. Oh, a counter DI from Guile. Oh, no. Oh, no. That looks like somebody's got a plan on him. Ooh. He's not even doing the thing. He just activated that for no reason. He's wasting the meter. He's with them. Oh, there it is. There it is. Guile had a plan. He was playing chess, I was playing checkers. I'm so sorry. Guile versus Jamie. Statistics say that this is a Guile match for sure, but Jamie's no slouch himself. Ooh. Okay. I got that 5 HP. Okay. Oh. He's just gonna do it. Level 3 time. This is what happens when Jamie has no drinks. He just does shit and it works. Okay. Ooh, palm for it. Alright, nice stare down. Unfortunately, Guile. Alright, ooh, good call there. Ooh, air to air is from Jamie. This is mad interesting, but a counter DI from Guile. He may be on the back foot, but he ain't that on the back foot. Oh, anti-air from Jamie. You gotta get a drink in, young man. Oh, he doesn't care. He wants to do this sober. Ooh. Oh no, Guile has a level 2 on his head. Okay. Good call though. He did his damnedest. Jamie just has to get some chip in. And unfortunately, I don't think God's letting him. Oh, with a sliver of health, he gets the 5 HK. That was a great call. Unfortunately. Who won that? Jamie won that? Good job. I think Jamie's gonna be able to cook for this. He got 2 drinks in. He just DP'd. A third drink. Hey. Oh, it's different now. Cammy, fight back. Oh. Counter DI. Cammy fought back. Have you ever seen such tomfoolery like this? Kimberly did not have that good of a performance in her last fight, but with this level 3, I think she might. It might even be more crack if she's able to carry this level 3 buff with her. I don't know it to be true, but ooh. Good punch there. I think Kimberly's trying to take her team to the mountaintops. If DJ could rise from the ashes after such slander, I think Kimberly can do it too. All right. Kim versus Jury. Jury got them buttons, man. A nice level 1 here. Personally, I think she should have saved for a level 3, but if Kimberly's just gonna DI, we can DI back for days. And now Kim's in a terrible spot right now. Oh man, I know what happens here. Oh, she can build a level 3, but does she have a level 2 combo on her? We're playing Marvel. Okay. Alright. Kim's fighting back now. Jury had a good idea. I'm not gonna say she didn't because she just won that round, but this is not the fight we got before. Well, it kinda is because it's going down to the wire, but like it wasn't going down to the wire like this fight's going down to the wire. I think we're looking at a last touch kind of situation. Aki is working Jury right now. Hey, here comes a level 2? Tomfoolery. What's Jury gonna do? She's gotta hit Aki, and she does, but she's still poisoned because of the pool. Hits her again. Yeah, Rasheed's gonna have to do some heavy lifting. But Jury's gonna make sure it ain't that heavy. Lighten the load. Oh, the jump in. The jump in's gonna get you. Shout out to Aki, she's mad flexible. We've got Aki versus Rasheed. And ooh. Target combo from Aki. Giving Rasheed some terrible work. Rasheed is pretty much in the corner right now. Ooh, he's gonna have to fight his way back. He does. Isar? Ooh, yeah! Okay. Wasn't able to get that throw in, but he's on a pretty good run right now. Ooh. Okay. I was doing a whole lot of oohs, not a lot of commentating, but this is going blow by blow, and then Rashid gets the final hit needed. His neutral's just slightly better than hers. And now Rashid's gonna have to be the one to defeat JP. I don't like his odds. And I think JP came to play. He might be the closer. He's got 2.5 bars left. It's looking pretty good. But Rashid's got some drive rush combos. Everybody's got 2 bars now. JP's close to 3. Oh, he didn't do the level 3. He didn't believe in it enough. But one touch is all JP needs. Rashid needs multiple. Nah, JP's panicking. Oh, there it is. He just did it. Whoa. JP just did it. He needed one touch. He got that one touch. And because of that, JP will be taking the new generation to run it back in the grand finals against the team of Fair and Honest Fighters. Let us begin. If the new generation managed to win, the bracket will be reset and the new generation will be able to fight one last time to win the grand finals. But if Fair and Honest wins once, then Fair and Honest are the grand finals champions. That's how this works. That's how this will be. We're getting a good back and forth between Luke and Ryu as we speak. Luke is putting Ryu in the corner. Ryu has a little more than half, but negligibly so. Okay, good fights here. Ooh, crouching in K, Hadouken. DI, counter DI from Ryu. Is this the first time Luke doesn't win in his first fight? Ryu is different. My word, my God. It was scrapping. Now we've got Ryu versus Jamie. Hadouken here. Okay, jump in from Jamie there. Ooh, plus frames. All right, Ryu's got to figure Jamie out here. Ooh, kick. DI, but it worked the way Jamie would have liked. They're just poking at each other right now. Somebody's going to blow things up, and I think Ryu just did it. Ooh, a Hashigeki? A Shin Hashigeki. Yikes. You got a drink now, Jamie. Oh my God, a perfect pairing. All right, this is a perfect parry combo, so Jamie does not die from that. But if he doesn't block the short Yuken, he might as well. And there it is. The anti-air. All right, Kim, are you the difference maker? Are you the difference maker we've been looking for? She is. She just connects for a level 3. Does she get the buff? This is a really important thing, because I don't think I ever actually checked. Does she get the buff? If she did before, I wasn't paying attention. So now it's time to see if she actually gets that buff here. No buff. She's going to have to do the whole rigmarole again. That's unfortunate, especially because she's going to need all the help she can get against the Marissa. Uh-oh. Kimberly's turning up. She's going to redeem herself against DJ at this rate. No, I counter DI from Marissa. That's my baby. Oh, it's the old reliable. Evened up the score. Okay. Ooh, good job from Kim. Another DI from Kim and countered by Marissa. I think this is it. It's gotta be it. She did the level 3. I wouldn't have gone with that bar. I wouldn't have gone with that verse. Of all the times to do a level 2 that Marissa's been doing, I think that was one of those times, but you know, sometimes you just gotta make that statement for it. It's not looking good. It's not looking good. Okay. Ooh. Okay. Nice from Marissa. Now Aki's in the corner. What happens here? Oh, we got more combo to spare. All right. Hey. Ooh. Marissa's bullying. She is bullying Aki right now. Aki's got to find a way to fight back. A DI. Nice job. She ate the Gladius hit and is able to defeat Marissa. Now it's time for DJ. And as we've seen, DJ can make or break an experience here. So it's up to Aki to stop it as best she can. Someone's got to do the heavy lifting. It's either Aki or JP. There we go. Oh, DI, who won that? Aki wins that. Hey, I think we're gonna see. No, we're not gonna see that level 3. No, we are. We are. I was not familiar with this combo. And that's a magnum opus. Ninja just lost 60% of his health. It's different now. He's gotta really fight for this one. Ooh, okay. Oh, I think he did. It's time for the rhythm. 4, 5. Oh, he's got no rhythm. But he does have a counter DI. Oh, man. And now it's JP. The last bastion of the new generation. The white wolf of the new generation. Good call on DJ there. Hey! Ah, that didn't kill. Okay. He needs one hit on him. It doesn't matter. DJ tried to counter DI. It doesn't matter. He didn't have the health to do that. JP leaves. Now it's JP versus Lily. I don't know what happens here. Good on JP. We're gonna make it a full screen game right now. Does a snap? He did it again. Oh, he's so cool. Oh, JP does not care. He is at his home field advantage. Oh, he just does it. He doesn't care anymore. Nah. Lily's fighting back now. Okay. Oh, Lily's super fighting back. It's not looking good for JP. And JP beats Lily with the overhead ghost. JP with 3 bars versus Ken with 3 bars. I was so worried we would not see this encounter because that's what I made the thumbnail of this video. Can Ken get his revenge on JP? A sweep. Okay. A DI. JP's gotta go crazy off this. And he does, level 3 combo. What's Ken going to do? Does JP have the hopes and dreams of his people? Will the new generation reset the bracket? Maybe not. Level 3 from Ken, it's not gonna kill. If it was a critical art, it would have. Probably not, actually. Ooh, force knockdown. JP didn't know about it. Oh, and that's it. JP reset the bracket. JP reset the bracket. A new generation has one more shot. They have to defeat Farron Onis one more time, right? Now Farron Onis is in the loser's bracket, and new generation need to just win one more time. Let's see what happens. And now here we go. Brackets reset. Luke versus Ryu. New gen. Now kind of sort of in the... They're both in the loser's bracket, but like this, the bracket has now been reset. So here we are. Ooh, and Ryu says we're gonna be dominant today. Ooh, kick. Yeah. Ooh, okay. Luke's gotta get serious here. He's gotta do it. DI-ing the fireball. Flash knuckle combo. Nah, just a rising uppercut there. Another rising uppercut. He cross cuts those. Ooh. And Ryu just outspaced him there. Shin Hashigeki. Hey. Well fought. Luke was not able to pull it off again. And now we got Jamie versus Ryu. Oh no. He said he's gonna splurge on it. Arguably, he didn't have to. But meter management is a myth. Ooh, perfect parry already? Good thing Marissa didn't have meter. She'd have used it. Okay. Oh, and she folded him like a pretzel. That's not good. That's how you make a statement. Jamie is not deterred, though. But Marissa just got her in. Hey. Ooh, where did Jamie's health go? And there it is. Now it's Kim versus Marissa. I don't know. I couldn't tell you what happens here. The new generation had a lot of momentum going for it. It would be a shame to see it all go now. Hey, ooh. Good punch by Marissa. Good lord. Ooh, yeah. Kim's health is leaking again. A counter DI from Marissa. This is how people lose, Kim. That's exactly how people lose. Ah, Kim, you can't make those kinds of mistakes. Marissa says she's going to be the one to carry the team. Aki's going to have to do a good chunk of heavy lifting, right? You don't want JP to carry for too long because he's prone to start making mistakes. Aki's going to, at the very least, have to get Marissa out of the way. Get the person who's bleeding all the health out the way and things get a little better, right? And at the very least, hurt DJ a bunch. Unfortunately, Marissa says it's time to put the team on her very, very broad and sexy shoulders. D.I. Aki was not ready. Oh, Aki was ready for that. Level 3. Is that enough, though? Oh, it's a super magnum opus. Yo! And it's death. And it's death. Aki heard the rules. Aki heard the challenge. She said, okay, I'll do it. I believe. And I believe. It's gotta be done. It's gotta be done. Bubble. DJ lands on it. And now DJ's getting poison damage. Ooh. Counter hit on Aki. Doesn't matter though. That can neutral. Oh, DJ just got some damage in. If he can. Ooh, that doesn't kill. That doesn't kill. That doesn't kill. But Aki just needs to hit once. Yep, there it is. Yeah, that was ugly. That was ugly. Can JP do it? Can JP do it at home? Okay, JP, what you got for him? Hey, hey. Ooh, ooh, ooh. Mink Minks. Ah, DJ is watching the health bleed from JP. Oh, counter DI from JP. Let's go. Hey, hey, hey. Ooh, ooh, good spike there, good spike there. Okay, we're playing the zoning game now. Nice. Yeah, DJ's just gonna have to be miserable now. Oh no. One good confirm. DJ only ever needed one good confirm, but he was pressing buttons he did not believe in. So JP gets to stay a little longer. If he beats Lily. And I don't believe that's going to be the case. Lily has access to level 3. The only way he's going to be able to beat Lily is if Lily just does not touch him. And if you're going to round start DI, Lily's probably going to touch him. But unfortunately, JP just built 3 bars on his own. Is it going to end in ruin for the team of fair and honest fighters? No! Lily did a level 2, not a level 3. What was she thinking? That would have killed! It's getting spicy. Oh, and JP didn't block the DI. He didn't counter the DI. He pressed the button that could counter into it, and he just didn't. And so Lily, the poster child for this is not the face of mercy, robs JP of his dreams. It hurts. It hurts. It hurts. It hurts. If you were a Team New Gen fan, it's not necessarily a Cinderella story or an underdog story, but man, oh man, oh man, when they reset the bracket, I just know mountains are moved. I just know that. And so, we have ended the tournament here. We have ended the tournament here. Our champions of the Street Fighter 6 Tag Tournament are Team Fair and Honest. Congrats to all the fighters involved. Congrats to everybody who watched it, everybody who participated in it, everybody who bet. If you lost money, if you won money, congrats to you. Thank you for watching. If this gets mad popular, then we'll do another one of these, or we can just do a traditional fight 2 rounds and then move on to the next person type of team tournament. But in the meantime, like I said in the beginning of this video, Dragon Ball Madness is looming over the horizon, and there's a lot of work that gets done into that. So if I disappear off the face of the earth, don't you worry. That's exactly where I went. Time. But anyway, I'm the Shady Champ, the most trustworthy gamer that you know. And this has been an awesome experience. Bye-bye.